In this video, you're going to see how to use the discuss feature in Bolt, how it works, how it can save you time and tokens and search the internet and bring more context into Bolt. And I'm going to show you how valuable it is. And in doing so, we're going to build an app like Things 3. I know it's another to-do list app, but we do add AI functionality to break down a task and give you kind of step-by-step instructions for specific tasks. But the main purpose of this video is showing you this new discuss feature that Bolt has. So let's get into it. So I'm just gonna say I want to build a simple to-do list app like Things 3. I'm gonna send that in. We're gonna add AI to this to make it more complicated. But what I wanna do is start with that, have something basic that works. So I'll pause the video and I'll come back once it is ready. Okay, so we have our basic app here. And if I click add tasks, go to the gym, click add tasks, and there we go, it is added. And then if I want to add another, clean my room, I can put a due date, it looks like. I click enter or add task, there we go. So now I have multiple tasks showing up here. Pretty cool. Okay, so what I want to show you in this video is this discuss feature. So this discuss feature allows you to plan out tasks in Bolt before actually doing it, which should first save you tokens because you don't have to go back and forth as much. I think it's one message in discuss equals 10 messages in actual build mode. So what I want to do is plan out a new feature. So let's say I want to add a feature to drag tasks and drag them above, up or down to move the order. Let's plan it out. Okay, so I'm in discuss mode, and what it's going to do is come up with a plan for this. So it's coming up with a library that can do it and just everything that we need to do for this. So now I'm going to click implement the plan. Now, of course, we could have potentially just had it build that initially, but with that discuss mode, it should be a lot more likely to do it successfully on the first try because it has a plan. It's essentially creating a plan before actually building it out. So let's pause the video and see how it does. Okay, here we are, and it looks like it is working perfectly. I can drag and drop. Okay, pretty amazing. The next thing I want to do, okay, and then I'm completing it. They're getting there, pretty good. So the next thing that I would like to do is add let's say we want to add AI into this app, just for the sake of showing you how this works. We're going to go back to discuss, and something else that discuss has, which is really great, is it can search the internet and get information from the internet. So I'm going to say I want to integrate OpenAI into this app and then add a button to press on the task, which will give me a breakdown of how to successfully complete the task. Okay. So I'm going to say research the OpenAI API documentation of how to integrate into that. So I'll send that away. So first it's going to research the OpenAI documentation, which it researched it, and now it's coming up with a plan based on all of that. And then here on the top, we can see the sources that it looked at. That also happened really, really quickly, which is really impressive. So if we click on it, we can see this is the OpenAI API reference. So it went right there, which is perfect. So it came up with a plan, the API endpoint, securely, et cetera, et cetera. So I'll say, okay, great. It's giving me the task to do. So the first step was install the OpenAI client. So let's do that first. Oh, you know what? We're still in discuss mode. I'm going to roll back to checkpoint. So what I'm going to do is get out of discuss mode, and I'll say execute on the above plan. So if you're in discuss mode, it's going to tell me how to do it, but I don't want to do it. I want the agent to do it for us. So let's let it do it. Looks like there's already an error, but it's still coding, so let me just let it go ahead and do that, and then I can attempt the fix later. Let me just see. Yeah. Okay, so I'll pause the video, and we'll let it do this update. Okay, so it just asked me to connect to Supabase, so I just went ahead and did that, and now it's going to connect to Supabase, which is going to be needed for that OpenAI connection. So it's going to go ahead and do that. And I'll pause the video while it's finalizing the setup. So now I'm just going to say, okay, let's fully implement the AI feature now that Supabase is connected. Okay, so this is another good example. So now it's saying set the OpenAI key in my soup secret. So I'm going to say, and go back to discuss, I'm going to say, how do I deploy and set the OpenAI API key? So let's see what it says. Okay, so this is how we need to deploy that edge function. So you go to Supabase, there's a link, we'll click deploy via CLI. Oh, it looks like no, it already did deploy because I can see that the task breakdown is there. So I think that it just doesn't know that actually. So one second. So I'm going to say it is deployed, but then I need to go to environment variables. This I think I need to do. So OpenAI API key. So I'm going to copy that. Let's go to, okay. So the way that you get to that is through edge functions and then to secrets. And then this is where we're going to add open underscore API underscore key. And then we're going to add our API key there. So I'm going to grab mine real quick. Okay, let's just test it out. So let me add a task. It'll be, why don't it say cook a chicken dinner? So we're going to add the task. And now let's click this little light bulb, which I'm assuming is the AI, but nothing is happening. So I'm going to say I'm added the API key. Clicked the light bulb in the UI, but nothing happened. And I'm gonna do the discuss mode again and see if it's able to see what's happening. So it's giving me a plan. I can verify it was deployed. So I'm gonna say debug this, please, out of discuss mode. And here I can see it is updating that edge function, or that's updating the code at least. And now let's test it again. Okay, so at least we made some progress. Now it says fail to fetch. Let's discuss the problem first because we're testing out this feature a lot. I want to see how it works. So it's come up with a plan. So let's fix it. I'll just assume that the plan is good. So it seems like it has to do with response parsing, which is a pretty good issue to have. So now let's click on this light bulb again. Again, fail to fetch. Let's attempt fix again. Okay, let's try a light bulb again. There we go, generating breakdown. Okay, perfect. Awesome. So now it worked correctly and we got a cool breakdown. So I imagine if I click that, then it'll go away. If I click it again, I guess it generates again. So we could save that. There's other things that we could do. But that's the main thing that I wanted to show in this video is how to use this new discuss feature on in Bolt. It can search the internet, it can help you debug things, and it's just a way to build without using as many tokens and also just help give more knowledge to Bolt. So if you like this video, be sure to like the video, subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more free content like this. Click the link in our description to go to No Code MBA to learn more about building with no code and AI tools. We have dozens of in-depth tutorials teaching you how to build websites, apps, and automations. And if you have any questions at all, or if there's anything you want to see in the future on this channel, leave a comment below. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.